been around her all the time.
I see. Jim Fletcher, do I detect a glint of green in those pretty eyes?
I'm serious, Terry.
Vera, I'm not doing anything for Kathy that I wouldn't do for the other prisoners. It's our job to protect them. That's all I'm doing.
Is that why you spoke to Inspector Grace?
Who told you?
Bill on the gate. You're not to be fooled by that man. He's a professional ratbag, out for information at all costs.
He just might be able to help her.
Oh, rubbish. I won't stand for it. You've got to drop any deal you might have made with him. Now, if you've still got some feelings left
Which I haven't.
Then drop it. Please, for me.
It means that much to you?
Yes, it does.
Look, Vera, I keep telling you, Kathy doesn't mean anything to me anymore. I got over her years ago.
Yes, I know, I'm sorry. I just get nervous. You know. Will you promise me?
All right. All right, I promise.
Right, Paige. This is a cell inspection. I thought I told you to make your bed.
I did.
There's a right way and a wrong way. This is wrong.
Well, I didn't know.
You should have asked some of the other women. Now do it again and do it properly. I'll be back shortly.
Oh, hi. I heard we had a new neighbour in this cell.
Hello.
Hello. I'm B. Smith. I'm in charge as far as the women are concerned. Vinegar Tit's been giving you trouble.
Who?
Miss Bennett.
Oh, she said I had to make the bed again properly.
Oh, yeah. She's a bit fussy about that. What's your name, love?
Alison Page. Mrs.
Right. Well, there you go, Alison. This is the way she likes it made. Just like that.
Thank you.
That's okay. We've got to stick together in here against the likes of her.
Oh, I'm only in for 3 months. Two, if I get remission.
Listen, love. You need friends in a place like this, even if you're only in here for 3 days. It's pretty tough going it alone. Oh, that's for breakfast. You hungry? You won't be when you see the tucker. Come on, I'll take you to the dining room.
Oh, yuck.
Oh, don't blame me. I only dish it up.
Hey, Lizzie, maybe we could organise another ride alarm today. That was real good getting stuck in maternity.
Yeah.
Hmm. Well, never mind, Lizzie. It could have been worse, you know. You could have got locked in the storeroom with only Vinegar for company.
No, maternity was great. We stayed there and played games with kids for ages.
You did. I only read them fairy stories.
Oh, you sure it wasn't too hard for you?
Good morning, ladies. Got a new chum on deck today. This is Alison Page. Alison, Judy, Doreen, and that's Lizzie, the prison mascot.
Hello.
Hello, Alison. It's nice to have a new face around the place.
How long are you in for, love?
3 months.
Oh, that'll pass in a minute.
Come and have some brekkie. They call it porridge, but I reckon it's for laying bricks. There you go.
You stupid idiot. How dare you do that to me?
Oh, come off it. It was only an accident.
Keep out of it, you common little fun.
Common little... You here.
She's not exactly a social type, is she?
Oh, I think it's all a bit beyond her at the moment.
Yeah, bloody stuck-up bitch. That's what she is.
Yeah, not real friendly, is she? Yeah, well, she's gonna have to come down to Earth sooner or later and realise just where she is.
Not hungry, Paige?
I can't eat it.
Well, that's up to you. But after a day or two, you'll realise it's all there is. And suddenly it tastes a lot better.
Cheer up. We've been eating this muck for years and we're still alive.
You call this living?
Come in.
You wanted to see me, Mrs. Davison?
Yes, Mr. Harrison. It has come to my notice that you were once married to Kathy Hall. Is that correct?
Yes, yes.
Why have you said nothing about it?
Well, I don't think it was important. Our marriage ended ages ago. I haven't seen her in 10 years.
There have been occasions in the past where relatives of staff members have been on the wrong side of the bars, and it has proved somewhat of an embarrassment. My own niece was at Wentworth, as was Mrs. Morris's stepdaughter, And in both cases, we found it necessary to make other arrangements.
You're going to transfer Hall?
I think it advisable.
Mrs. Davison, could I ask you not to Barnhurst anyway?
Why?
I think whoever's making these threats against Kathy Hall belongs to a crime syndicate. Now, Barnhurst is a medium security prison. If you send her there, they'll have no trouble in getting to her and finishing the job.
Crime syndicate?
Yes.
Isn't that being a bit dramatic? It could be one of the inmates here making the threats.
I don't think so. This is serious. They tried to kill her.
I do not want to place an officer in a compromising or embarrassing situation.
Believe me, Mrs. Davison, you won't be. Kathy Hall means nothing to me.
All right, Mr. Harrison. I shall postpone transferring her for the time being.
Thank you.
But now that I am aware of the situation, I shall be keeping a close eye on it. I do not want a repeat of the Margot Gaffney incident.
No, of course not. Don't worry, Mrs. Davison. We'll find the person who's making these threats.
We certainly will, Mr. Harrison. One way or another.
Hey, Lizzie, you're not your usual smiling self today.
Yeah, me? I'm all right.
Anything on your mind you want to talk about?
No.
Oh, hi, Kathy. How you going?
I'm all right, I suppose. Doc reckons I'm fit enough to work again.
Well, welcome back to the land of the living.
Any idea who bashed you? Anything you didn't tell the screws?
No, Bea, I haven't got a clue.
All happened so quick and they got me from behind.
Well, as far as I can find out, Dinah Walford had a bit of time she couldn't account for. She said she was in D block, but I don't know.
Yeah, but I don't know her.
Yeah, nor is anybody else. She could be looking for someone on the outside. Pity I couldn't have a longer chat with her.
Well, why couldn't you?
She got out yesterday, Arva.
Well, I reckon they were out to stop me talking to that cop. I know they were.
Well, relax. I'm pretty certain it was Dinah. Now she's no longer here, you should be safe as houses.
Yeah. What happens if it wasn't her?
Morning, Alison. Remember me?
Mrs. Morris, yes, of course.
I was hoping I wouldn't be seeing you again. Especially not in here. But now that you are here, let's make the most of it, eh? Have you been assigned to a workplace yet?
They're going to put me in the laundry. But couldn't I just stay in my room?
Well, 3 months is a long time in a small cell.
But you can get me out, please. Like you did last time. Don will pay the fine.
Alison, I can't. It's gone beyond that now. You've been sentenced, and there's no way I could change the magistrate's ruling. The report I did on you before was good enough to get you off on a fine, but now...
I can't face it, Mrs. Morris. 3 months in here with these terrible women.
Oh, come on. Well, tell me about it. Why did you steal again? I mean, you knew it would lead to this.
I tried. Really, I did. Don and I had a heart-to-heart talk after the last time. We got closer than we had done in years. I told him I was sick and tired of running the business from the home, answering phones, trying to get meals ready.
He's a builder, isn't he?
A plumber. I wanted to get a job, just part-time, enough to give me an outside interest. We never went out at night. I was stuck in that house 24 hours a day.
Alison, I know the gambling gave you a bit of excitement, but this is your third offence for stealing. You can't expect the courts to keep letting you off because you've got gambling debts to pay.
All I ever needed was for someone to tell me that I was doing a good job, just a word of encouragement now and again. It's not the gambling. I could do without that.
You don't think you have a problem, then?
Of course not. I just got in too far over my head, that's all, and I panicked. I didn't want Don to find out.
Well, he certainly knows now, doesn't he?
But I can't stand it in here. I can't stay with those women.
Alison, you've got to make the best of it. By refusing to mix with them, you'll only make it worse.
But you've got to do something. You must help me. What am I going to do?
Have a look at her. She's miles away. Have either of you found out what's upsetting her yet?
No. Me neither. Must have been something to do with Sid, though. Maybe they had a blue or something.
Well, we're going to have to do something to cheer her up.
Well, what do you suggest?
Watch it, you lot, Fletch.
Right, ladies, I think most of you know Alison Page. Smith, show her what to do, will you?
Mr. Fletcher.
What is it, Smith?
I want to make a phone call.
Phone call? Who do you want to phone?
A friend. Come on, I haven't used the phone for ages. Must have plenty of calls and credit.
All right, come on. Brian, show Page the ropes, will you?